And welcome, punters, to the salubrious offices of Slattery Media for the Racetrack Ralphie weekly waffle. Racetrack Ralphie, Danny Power, the thoroughbred who would be known as the voice of reason. Were Jared Waitley not already the voice of reason? And Jared's got a sequel coming out, Dan.
Black Caviar?
Black Caviar, why not?
Beautiful.
Yeah.
He did a good job with the first one.
Exactly.
It's a good read.
Yeah. She's handy.
Pity you missed the... They stopped at the race in the first one, otherwise he would have had the killer bee story.
The killer bees.
Attached to it, but that'll probably lead to...
Very biblical. We can have frogs next and locusts, the works. Well, she's the best, equal best I've ever seen. Because I can't split McIvy. Everyone's aiming for the Melbourne Cup, it's our iconic race. Do you have to?
No, you don't have to split them.
Don't have to split
Because they're
them.
Totally different types of horses, aren't they? Depends on the pleasure they give you and the thrill they give you. The best horse I've seen, thoroughbred I've seen, is still Vain. So,
yeah.
As much as I'm inspired by her and think that she's absolutely wonderful, Vain is the benchmark for me, and I don't see her as any better than Vain.
Even though Vain only did it once, 1 year, is that right? 2 years?
No, really, one
two
year.
Two or three?
No, yeah, we didn't run the autumn, only.
Yeah, one calendar year.
Yeah, had 14 starts, 112. Roy Higgins got him beaten twice. He rode him once and then beat him with another horse rating. And won the Caulfield Guineas. Two weeks later, back to from a mile to 1,200. Won the Croven A Stakes, which is the open sprint, down the straight.
Yep.
By 12.
Yep.
Backed up on the Thursday. Won the Wait for Age 1,400 Linlithgow by 5. Stepped up on the Saturday in the mile again.
Mm-hmm.
Carried Stone more than Wait for Age, won the George Adams Mile.
Dan,
not bad.
Yeah, not bad.
Black Caviar's never done anything like that.
It was a slightly different era, Dan. Could you get me some of that for my breakfast tomorrow morning? Because I'll just probably do some weights, I reckon. Anyway, there you know, if you're watching this for the first time, well, it's called The Weekly Waffle. This is part one, and we look back at Flemington, which didn't include, obviously, Black Caviar.
Yep.
But in the first race, sometimes you're just going to trust what you see. Don't overthink it. I was very guilty later in the day of overthinking something. We'll get to it. But Caskets, overthink. Well, particularly with a head this size, but Caskets was the best run of Mini Valley. Easily
yep,
the best run.
It was.
And Annabooka was the second best run.
Yep.
Oh, sorry, of those running, the winner actually real good. But that politeness, that was the Spruce horse. But it didn't run better than those other two. I don't know what was in the market.
No. But it ran quite well on Saturday.
Yeah.
I thought, you know, I got out late and got home,
yeah.
I think.
But that's who ran better than it at Mooney Valley, ran better than it again.
Yeah, they did. I think the second horse, Annenberg, might be the better of the three of those. That's my gut feeling. I like the way she got to the front, ducked in onto the fence, and then kept finding when the other horse who had the drop on her. I wouldn't have been surprised in another 50 metres she would have kicked back and beaten the winner.
Suspect these are the B graders, though.
Yeah, but they're the big raiders for two-year-olds, but they might be
progressive
three-year-olds. You know, I think
that Caroline word that one progressive.
Yeah. Annenberg, boomed by Artie Schiller.
Yep.
You would think it'd be a better three-year-old.
Second race here now. Leave me out if that's a $1.80 chance. You don't take a $1.80 on a horse that wins by this much. Danny the Fox.
No.
Every possible cosmic moderate pace kicked away. Cosmic Causeway is just crying out for the 1600 next start Kilmore Cup. Will turn the tables. It was truckloaded. I think Robbie Waterhouse tipped it, which is probably one of the reasons why. And I was going to sit forward. And the other head scratcher that you had was New York. New York's a better horse going back.
Mm.
They went forward. Not necessarily. I like him erring on the side of being positive. But that horse cannot ping when it goes forward.
Yeah. I think the winner's a nice horse. He was good at Caulfield against Population, who ran along and just got him off the bit at the top of the straight. Came again. And was hitting the line strong, which is what you like to see. And I think it was just where he was going to position in that race.
Yeah.
With Boss, Mick Price. And Price was putting a fair spruik on the horse. He said it was his best at Caulfield. He virtually declared him his best again.
Mm.
I think that's why he's $1.80.
Won by that much. Causeway next up. We'll beat it in Kilmore Cup. Now, I thought I was in for a big day come race three because I couldn't have worked that out any better. Ominous Quality I had on top from Perfectly Ready and stated that Perfectly Ready would be midfield defence.
Perfectly stunning. The dad.
Yep, Perfectly Stunning, same colours. Said it would be midfield defence needing luck. Ominous Quality should get in as the best horse. Ominous Quality didn't get in. Perfectly Stunning had the luck. That was the difference in running. They both ran super.
Both Both ran super. Ominous Quality, a cracking looking mare. I just loved her in the parade. Made me want to go and have something on her. Again, another horse that sat wide at the 1400 metres at Flemington with no cover and still had a kick. So don't be worried if you're out there. A lot of people said Craig Newitz was the ride of the day. It was the lucky ride of the
exactly
day.
Exactly right.
The lucky ride of the day.
Yeah, well, like we saw in Soft Sand through the spring, it kept on drawing inside, and the luck didn't come. Once they're in that position, you need other things to work for.
I'm happy for them to ride that way, but don't say they're brilliant rides when the split comes. If they make a decision to go out, then come in and do the dodge and weave, that's a different thing. But he just sat there and hoped. Kane got the money. Nice filly, though. Nice mare.
Don't fall into the get back run-ons, but at Pingle, first up, you couldn't have asked for any more. It was super.
That's fine.
Race four, now I started to get the shakes because I thought I worked it out well with Shoe One. Maybe Keep Cool. Alfie Matthews, very critical of Keep Cool's ride, saying he went for home at the 400 after it over-raced. Couldn't believe what I heard. It was traded $1.17 on the fair. I was never confident it was going to win the way it raced in transit. Shoe One was super, but Bells of Troy is just an emerging stayer, full stop.
Yeah, I think it is. And this was a better ride by Craig Newitt because he sat and sat. He got onto Shuan's back. He realised that before the home turn, it was the one to tack onto. Just a patient ride. If he had have gone earlier, I don't know whether he would have won. It was just a perfect ride. I'm not worried about Jake Noonan going too early. Sometimes when a horse runs, somewhere along the way, you've got to let it stride. If you keep holding it up, it actually doesn't give you anything. So I reckon he just said, I can't hold you anymore. I've got to let you run and see if we can find the finish. And he couldn't.
An Elusive King. That's what happens when horses forget how to win. Alzora won first up. I couldn't have enough fit. Second horse is good. You're so good. Third horse should have won. Petite Diabolus missed the start. Baluk, super through gears. And Kaz and Luck, Karen, you had a bad day. That was one of them.
Yes. Over race when he went forward on her out of the gate.
I don't think he had a great plan out of the gate. No, it was one of those, let's try and find a position.
Yeah, I don't know what the instructions were, but he went forward and then no cover, over-raced. It went all right, it'll be fine.
Yeah, so I actually reckon that Elzora won, but I think the second, third, fourth and fifth are better than
her. I think it's a strong race.
Sheer Talent won the next, and unfortunately it was a great ride by Stevie Baxter. Pair closer than I thought, and that was the difference. I had Hosting at good odds and Force Command at super odds. I know why, because Robbie Woodhouse tipped it and it's of its class, but Albrecht was always going to be back last one off, and why it got truckloaded in the was just ridiculous.
No, I don't understand that either, because it was always going to be back. They didn't go hard.
No.
So really, Albrecht and Bass Strait, especially Bass Strait, went fine. They went fine as far as I was. A lot of people want to say, oh, Albrecht, you know.
32.5 Albrecht between the 800 and 200. You can't go quicker. So
it was fine.
I think they're going to Sydney with it. And it can win first up in Sydney.
Well, its first starter went into the parade ring with five legs, yelling and screaming.
Hard to run when you got one.
Yelling and screaming. So if you get the first up run, that was a much better run. It'll be fitter, primed. And then they'll say, the Melbourne were glad to get rid of it. You just got to look at these races and study them and say, it didn't go too bad. Why do we want to pot the horse? Don't pot it.
And Philippi is a strong horse. He'll get stronger.
2,000 metres. Why did he get to 2,000 metres?
And he could knock off all Tuart over a mile. There you go. Black Caviar, we talked about. Moment of Change was super. Not much to add, is it? It's all been covered.
Oh, second was sensational. Moment of Change just went super.
When you hear about a straight track specialist, it's an often overused term, but for mine, the data says why Belfast Boy is. He can sit near the speed, but he's got that genuine acceleration from the 400 to the 200 because it's a building pressure, the straight. It's the one who can really ping off. And I don't think Craig Newitt wanted to lead on to circles. Don't blame him. No. Nothing else was there.
Nothing there. No. It went fine. Yeah. In fact, he was under pressure a long way out. Like, he asked it a long way out. The fact that it kept giving was fantastic.
Don't tumble into this. It's not a non-winner. It's had two starts as a gelding. Second to Rescue Mission, good form. In the wrong spot, good form. I can't wait for it next start because they'll over risk it because of that. The odds were stupid. I mean, I had a clear top pick, but 325, the 250 was ridiculous. The rest of them, they all just followed each other home. War Charm was a good run, but just 1200. I just couldn't get into the market 1200 because it's a 1400 horse.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I need to study that race again to see what value is in the others.
And last race, we can't underline anymore how well Nick and Noise as a poster boy for the David Hayes transformation. They're winning races with horses that are probably there. They're now getting to there. Last year they had horses that were there running like that.
He was miles overs. His run in the spring was terrific, I think. Yeah. Was it Oaks Day?
Yeah, it was.
Won the second race on Oaks Day. He was miles overs. Good, solid horse. A much better, a really good ride by Jake Noonan. He got him out. He's a wind-up horse and got him out and wound him up.
Well, the wind-up horses ran the trifecta because it was hard pressure early. Caused by, what were they thinking with the new boy? So, let's be cute. Apprentice who's had a head injury after a long absence, thrown in the deep end, Kate Lemellian. I reckon it's really unfair on her. And then she's caused all the pressure because at first I went, oh, I'll just go a bit quieter. The horse has been used to racing forward. There's no spot. Massive pressure course. So the three run horses ran 1, 2, 3. Mid River, if you can somehow get a break in the Melbourne weather, a 2,000 wet track would be a certainty at this time of year because it's running real well.
Won't get it, I don't think.
Probably not. Anyway, that's the look back at Flemington, and we'll have a break in segment 2. We'll crap on about the racing issues.